Oh, sorry. I was just finishing my lunch. This is just so embarrassing. Oh, we're talking about sandwich theorem? What a perfect segue!
Dun, 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 dun. Calculus with Krista. Today we're doing sandwich theorem, aka squeeze theorem, aka pinching theorem. It's called the sandwich theorem because it's about taking the jelly and smashing it in between the bread and the peanut butter.
See, all the sandwich theorem actually tells us is that if the bread is at zero right here, and the peanut butter is also at zero right here, if we know that the jelly has to go in between them, then we know that the jelly must also be zero right here. Trying to be a little more precise, if we know that this is peanut butter and we know that this is bread, if jelly must always be greater than or equal to peanut butter, we know that jelly has to be above or at least right on top of peanut butter. But if jelly also has to be less than or equal to bread, then we know that jelly has to be below or right on top of the bread. At the point x equals zero, we've shown that peanut butter and bread are equal to one another. They both pass through the point 0, 0, so they sit right on top of one another. If jelly is greater than or equal to peanut butter and less than or equal to bread, then the only possible value of jelly at x equals zero is zero.
Which means peanut butter and jelly and bread all occupy the same space at the same time, which makes for one delicious sandwich and a great analogy for the sandwich theorem. Sandwiches are delicious, and that's why you should download your free copy of my Calculus Essentials ebook by clicking the link down below, or the jelly-filled ones over here, aka squeeze theorem, aka pinching theorem.